Okay guys, so let's start unboxing this parcel that we have received. So let's cut it once again with our surgical blade. So this is a very small parcel that is come out from this, and I do see that they have put a small thing over here. Might be they wanted to put my bill here, but I don't see any bill in this, and I don't even see that the package was repacked by my courier company. So most probably my vendor did nothing over here on that box here and over here. So let's cut this from the box. Even there is no address here, but anyway, everything is written on the outer area, so it doesn't matter. Let's cut this. I find the surgical blade, I have a large surgical blade, I find the surgical blade to be very good for doing these kind of unboxings, because it's very sharp and it's able to pierce through much of the stuff. So what exactly are we going to find inside this box? I have been seeing a lot of guys who are into NAND flash recovery, typically into recovery of mobile phones, who are actually buying a lot of different eMMC readers for doing different for reading different kind of eMMCs. They are not aware about a solution which is universal, and we can do a couple of different styles of eMMCs in that. So this unboxing video that we are doing is of one of those kind of devices for eMMC which can read a couple of different kind of eMMCs. Although this can work independently also using an card reader, but very soon we'll have another video in which we will be using this device along with some specialized GSM boxes, so that we can work with semi-dead phones which are in a boot loop kind of stuff, and also with certain phones which are totally dead and we have to do a chip off, we have to actually remove the eMMC memory from that and then ultimately read it. So let's unbox this and have a look what kind of content do we have inside this small box. Now first of all, we have my commercial invoice. Thank you for sending this commercial invoice inside, because certain times if the custom people are inspecting and they find the same invoice inside, they are sure enough that nobody is under invoicing or over invoicing the goods that are coming into a country. You should all pay your taxes. So here you go. We have this is totally empty now. Let's keep it aside. And here we have that white box where we are going to take this out, and this is a 6-in-1 kind of a device. I mean, there are 6 different type of eMMC chips which this particular product will be able to read. So this is called Dr. Fix, and it's a 6-in-1 eMMC adapter. It can work with a couple of different GSM mobile phone boxes, like the Easy JTAG box, the Easy JTAG Plus, and Easy JTAG are one and the same thing. The Plus has some more content, because if a guy has Easy JTAG Plus, he might not require this. Then Riff and Riff Box 2, UFI, Medusa Plus, in fact, not Medusa, Medusa Plus, GPG, ORT eMMC, and I am sure it works with the EMMC Pro and the EMMC Booster also, which is not written over here, but I am very I'm sure it will work with that too. So let's take this box out and let's see what we have. Let's first take out the base of the product, because the base of the product is going to be the most interesting thing. So here we have the base in my hand. You guys can see. So the quality of this is absolutely par excellence. The PCB is of very good quality. There is absolutely no flex to that. Although the soldering is okay types, but I do find a few solders which are in a blob kind of condition right here, because I am very finicky about these kind of small things. So in this box you will see that it says RIF2 EZ2 GPG EMMC Pro EMMC Booster has to be connected here, Medusa Pro has to be connected here, Easy JTAG has to be connected here, RIF box over here, ATF box over here, UFI over here, and we have these different type of sockets around here. So this is the top BGA EMMC holder, which you can actually see. You can actually remove like this, and it has these different kind of connectors down below, which says EMMC 153, 162, 529, 221. So these are the different EMMCs it can work. And then we also have, so how do you make this work? For example, if you have an Easy JTAG box, what you can do is you can connect the Easy JTAG box here, and ultimately you can hook this thing on the top like this and then put your device and you can start reading it. So this is this kind of a socket in which you don't have to do any soldering is technically called the ZIFF socket, Z-I-F-F ZIFF socket. So this is a plastic ZIFF socket. I have also seen certain metallic ZIFF sockets, but I am yet to see an all-in-one kind of a box which has that kind of a solid metal kind of a socket over this. But if the plastic quality is good, I really don't think it makes a difference at all. Then we have this new some new connector they have, which says in-circuit programmer for boxes. So it's basically what it's doing is it's just pulling it up. What do I mean by pull up? Might be certain like CMD or D0, if you want pull up to like 100 ohms, might be this switch is doing that. So most probably this is for that. I have seen that modification being done in the box by some of the boxes, but more on this later because I am not aware, but I am very sure it's that only. Then let's unwind some more parts which are going to be little harder because there is a lot of small gadgets involved in this. So far so good. So we have these plastic compartments which can be changed. So how do you change those compartments is that you have these two screws here. So you unscrew these two screws and then you are able to take out the frame, the plastic frame out. And then you can change it with a different frame. So depending what kind of an EMMC you have, you can actually change the frame. We have one, we have two, we have three, we have four, we have five, and the sixth one is already installed inside. So these are the five frames which I have extra and one frame which is connected inside. And then we have another very interesting SD adapter. I was telling you that it is possible for this product to work independently. I'm not very sure in which connector I am going to hook this thing up, but in one of the connectors I am sure it can be connected. like this, and then you can put this SD interface into a SD card, and you don't need a separate box to work with this. So this is a very neat add-on that they have given along. So this is a nice thing. I wish you guys could do a little modification in this tool. Maybe you can have male pins over here, so that we can put the logic analyzer over here and analyze the pinouts once we are working, with this kind of a device. But anyway, it does not matter, because the main idea is to read the main stuff. So then we have one cable, possibly one cable to be routed from here to some other place. And then we have these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 separators, which possibly they want us to be connected on to 1, 2, 3, 4 holes here, so that most of the time when we keep this, it's not connected onto the bottom. It's not lying on the bottom like this on a hard surface. So they have given these 4 or 5 of them. So all said and done, it's a pretty neat tool. The only thing we need to see now is how does it work, and I'll try it out with a few BGA EMMCs. Once I'm a little bit comfortable about with this, then we'll make another video in which we will show you how this is being used and can be put to use for a data recovery environment. So all said and done, if you have any mobile phone which has a logical issue, or it's semi-dead or dead in and around Chandigarh, Haryana, Himachal, Punjab, north side of India, or any place in India. For example, your girlfriend has thrown your phone on the wall, or you have banged it on the wall, or your dog has chewed the mobile phone, or --, whatever you think. But you need the data. So be my guest, and this is your host from Chandigarh Data Recovery, Amarbir. Phone number 9815-000133, signing off. See you till the next video, guys. Bye.